Greetings and welcome to this first Sunday in Advent virtual worship service for Church of the Master Presbyterian Church located in Atlanta, Georgia. So very glad that you chose to worship with us on this Lord's Day. Our call to worship. Oh, that God would tear open the heavens and come down of that day or hour, no one knows, only God. Be alert, keep awake. The time is drawing near, the beginning of the good news of Jesus Christ, the Son of God. Let us worship God.
I am Ibrahim. Today our family is observing the first Sunday in Advent. We like the purple Advent candle.
We light this candle as a symbol of the hope we have in the promise of the Lord's coming.
For the Lord will fulfill his promise in the house of Israel and the house of Judah. A righteous branch will spring up for David, and he shall execute justice and righteousness in the land. Come, Lord Jesus, come.
Holy One, you have promised us that the day of our salvation is near. Keep us faithful in love and watchful in prayer, so that we may stand with confidence and joy at the coming of Christ, our Redeemer and Lord. Amen.
Our call to confession. Testify with honesty the condition of your soul. Give defense not for yourself, but only for the Lord's grace, which will save you in your time of trial. With confidence in God's mercy, let us confess our sins. Lord, have mercy on us. We're not ready for your coming. We live in sin as though there were no justice. We live in fear as though there were no grace. Forgive us, Lord. Show us your mercy and steadfast love. Lead us in your truth and teach us your paths. For you are the God of our salvation. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. Amen. Church, hear the good news. The saying is sure and worthy of full acceptance that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. He himself bore our sins in his body on the cross that we might be dead to sin, be alive to all that is good. I declare to you in the name of Jesus Christ that you are, I am, we are forgiven. Now go and do likewise and be at peace.
Jesus. us the light of the world. Christ, my highest heaven adored. Jesus, the light of the world. Christ, the everlasting Lord. Jesus, the light of the world. Beautiful light, come where the dewdrops of mercy shine bright. Shine all around us by day and by night. Jesus, the light of the world. Jesus, the light of the world. Jesus, the light of the world.
Please join me. Our prayer of illumination. Amid much confusion, signs leading away from you, we seek your truth. Open our hearts to the wonders of your work and the wisdom of your word. Amen.
Good morning. I am Brendan Michael with Church of the Master. Today I will be reading from 1 Corinthians chapter 1. Verses 3 through 9. Grace and peace to you from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Thanksgiving. I will always thank my God for you because of his grace given to you in Christ Jesus. For in him you have been enriched in every way with all kinds of speech and with all knowledge, God thus confirming our testimony about Christ among you. Therefore, you do not lack any spiritual gift, as you eagerly wait for our Lord Jesus Christ to be revealed. He will also keep you firm to the end, so that you will be blameless on the day of our Lord Jesus Christ. God is faithful, who has called you into fellowship with his Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Thank you, and may the Lord add his blessings to the reading of his word.
Our Old Testament reading will come from the book of Isaiah, chapter 64, verses 1 through 9. Listen for the word of God. Tear open the skies and come down to earth. The mountains will tremble before you. Be like a fire that burns twigs. Be like a fire that makes water boil. Do this so that your enemies will know who you are. Then all nations will shake with fear when they see you. You have done amazing things that we did not expect. You came down and the mountains trembled before you. From long ago, no one has ever heard of a God like you. No one has ever seen a God besides you. You help the people who trust you. You help those who enjoy doing good. You help those who remember how you want them to live. But you were angry because we sinned. For a long time we disobeyed. How will we be saved? All of us are dirty with sin. All the right things we have done are like filthy pieces of cloth. All of us are like dead leaves. Like the wind, our sins have carried us away. No one worships you. No one even asks you to help us. So you have turned away from us, and we are destroyed because of our sins. But Lord, you are our Father. We are like clay, and you are the potter. Your hands made us all. Lord, do not continue to be angry with us. Don't remember our sins forever. Please look at us, because we are your people. The word of God for the people of God.
Would you pray with me now as we pray our prayers of intercession? Merciful God, you call us to goodness and lead us on right path. You encourage us with signs of your coming and urge us to keep watch that we might greet you with heads raised high when you come to restore all of creation. Watching and waiting, we pray for this world that needs your saving power. Lord, in your mercy, we pray that you save us. For divisions of ideology that break relationships, for this global pandemic, for all who suffer from violence in the streets or in their homes, for all who live in worry or fear, for all who have forgotten the ways of righteousness, for those who have never heard of your rescuing love, for those who have lost hope or never had hope at all. In your mercy, Lord, save us. We pray too for your church in the world, that we may increase in order for you and your children and work in confidence for your coming reign. Now, by the power of your Holy Spirit, make us ever more faithful, that we may greet you in confidence and joy on that great day. Loving God, because we know something about you, we place these prayers of intercession, these pleas, these petitions before you. And we do it with confidence as we pray now the prayer you taught us by saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. 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 Sunday of Advent, I bid you peace, joy, and love. The sermon for today finds its basis in the gospel lesson, and that is Mark chapter 13, verses 24 through 37. Listen now for the word of God. But in those days after that suffering, the sun will be darkened, and the moon will not give its light, and the stars will be falling from heaven, and the powers in the heavens will be shaken. Then they will see the Son of Man coming in clouds with great power and glory. Then he will send out the angels and gather his elect from the four winds, from the ends of the earth to the ends of heaven. From the fig tree, learn its lesson. As soon as its branches becomes tender and puts forth its leaves, you know that summer is near. So also, when you see these things taking place, you know that he is near, at the very gate. Truly, I tell you, this generation will not pass away until all these things have taken place. Heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will not pass away. But about that day or hour, no one knows, neither the angels in heaven nor the Son, but only the Father. Beware, keep alert, for you do not know when the time will come. It's like a man going on a journey. When he leaves home and puts his slaves in charge, each with his work, and commands the doorkeeper to be on the watch. Therefore, keep awake, for you do not know when the master of the house will come, in the evening, or at midnight, or at cockcrow, or at dawn. Or else he may find you asleep when he comes suddenly. And what I say to you, I say to all. Keep awake. For the next little while, I would like to talk about watchfulness and waiting. Watchfulness and waiting. Pray with me, please. Loving Creator God, during this season of Advent, we take time to remember that you are ever faithful to your promises. During this season of prayer, penitence, and preparation, we rejoice as we remember all the goodness and grace you send our way each and every day. Merciful God, we come now to this preaching moment full of the special anticipation this season of the year brings. We pray now your presence in the word spoken and the word heard. Let it be for each of us just what we need in times like these. Now, God, for as much as without thee we're not able to please thee, mercifully grant that thy Holy Spirit may in all things that follow direct and rule our hearts through Jesus Christ our Lord, we pray. Amen. Amen. Watchfulness and waiting. Today is the first Sunday in Advent. The Advent season is the first season in the Christian church year. It marks a time of preparation, penitence, and prayer. It marks a time of expectation, waiting and watching for the coming Messiah, and it marks a time when we should conduct a self-inventory, if you will, you know, check ourselves to see if we're on the right path, on the right road, as we prepare for that magnificent day when God, through the person of Jesus Christ, comes and takes his own unto himself. Now, the word Advent comes from the Latin adventus, meaning coming. Inherent in the Advent season is the incarnation of Christ and the eschatological theme of his second coming. During Advent, we read scripture, recite litanies, and pray prayers of preparation and penitence. We also light candles to symbolize the ways we know Christ and the ways in which we watch and wait for the coming of Christ the King. We light a candle, which symbolizes hope, as we wait in hope for the Messiah's arrival. The candle is purple in color and symbolizes royalty, repentance, and fasting. We light a candle which represents peace as we await in peace, aware of the coming of Christ's ability to unify humankind. This candle is purple in color to symbolize preparation for the coming King. We light a candle which symbolizes love as we bask in Christ's perfect love. The color of the candle is pink to represent the culmination of love in Christ the King. We light a candle which represents joy as we rejoice in the wonder of God in the person of Jesus Christ. The color of the candle is purple to represent joyfulness and rejoicing. And finally, we light a fifth candle called Christ's candle. It is placed in the middle and is lit on Christmas Day or the last Sunday in Advent. The candle is white to represent the pure light and victory of the coming Christ. Beloved, there's a lot of watchfulness and waiting involved in the Advent season. And as we watch and as we wait, this Sunday scripture forces us, yes, it forces us to consider the triumphant return of Jesus Christ and the coming of God's new kingdom on earth. The scriptures focus on God's fulfilling of the promise to bring justice, righteousness, and redemption to all of humankind. And to that end, our gospel lesson is a bit disturbing. Indeed, it's not easy scripture. As a matter of fact, it's known among theologians as the Little Apocalypse, for it contains the elements of dualism, good versus evil, pessimism, times are extremely tough, and imminence, the world as we know it is about to come to an end. These elements often associated with readings about the end times or the eschaton. Moreover, this gospel lesson is an uncomfortable read, especially during this time of political upheaval, division in ideology, social unrest, economic uncertainty, worldwide pandemic steeped in dualism, pessimism, and imminence. That said, I contend that there is a word here for us, a word about watchfulness and waiting, a word that allows us to cry out with the first readers of this text saying, God, where are you? When are you coming? And a word that allows us to be reassured as we, along with the first readers of this text, hear Christ saying to us, I'm coming. Don't get stuck or sidelined by all the negatives. I'm coming. So you need to stay alert. Keep awake. Beloved, this text forces us to view the coming Christ, the watching and waiting for him, from an expectant place of new anticipation. In this text, the focus is not on December 25th, the celebration of the baby born in a manger. The focus is not on the cradle, but it is on the crown. Now, the cradle is easy for us. It is a fact. It is known. Yes, we have spent our lives celebrating what was. That is the cradle. So much so that the waiting associated with the cradle has become routine and co-opted by consumerism and commercialism. It is just what we do. We mark the days off the candle, off the calendar as the big day approaches. And when it gets here, we celebrate as usual. Yet this gospel text has none of that. In it, we are forced to watch and wait for Christ the King. We are forced to focus on the crown. Now, the good news in the text is that we're given some guidance on how we should watch and wait. We're told how to wait and to watch and to do it as if Christ the King has already come into our lives. Yes, we are to show the love of Christ in all we say and do. We are to trust the presence of our triune God in the moment, in this very moment. And we are to do justice and love kindness and walk humbly with our God. Further, we are not to fall asleep or get lulled into a state of complacency, embracing the negatives. Yes, even though discord and destruction can be all around us, we are called to be alert and watchful for the presence of Christ. Now, you may say, Reverend Doctor, how does that translate for the right here and now? Right here and now, which on most days looks a little apocalyptic. Well, our scripture reminds us that the Messiah has indeed come and dwelt among us. Our scripture reminds us that God longs to make good on the promise that has been made to humankind, and that God is very anxious to restore us to God's presence. And for our part, as we watch and as we wait for God's coming, we are to, in all that we say and do, we are to love the Lord our God with all our heart, our mind, our strength, and our neighbor as ourselves. For our part, as we watch and we wait, we are to do justice and love kindness and walk humbly with God. For our part, as we watch and as we wait, we are to be peacemakers, bridge builders, and hope givers. Yes, as we remain alert while watching and waiting for the coming Christ, because we know something about God in the person of Jesus Christ, in the midst of all the negativity, political upheaval, division in ideology, social unrest, economic uncertainty, worldwide pandemic, because we know something about God in the person of Jesus Christ, we should be like St. Francis of Sales and respond by living these words he wrote. He wrote, "Do not look forward to the changes and chances of this life in fear. Rather, look to them with full hope that as they rise, God, whose you are, will deliver you out of them. God is your keeper. God has kept you hitherto. Do you but hold fast to his dear hand, and he will lead you safely through all things. And when you cannot stand, he will bear you in his arms. Do not look forward to what may happen tomorrow. Our Father will either shield you from suffering, or he will give you strength to bear it. What a way, what a wonderful way of watching and waiting and remembering how to live in such a time as this. Yes, we should always remember as we watch and as we wait for the coming Christ that God is with us. Yes, that is the promise that we stand on as we live a life in Christ. Staying alert, keeping awake, means remembering whose and whose you are. It means living in the promise of God where there is always hope, peace, love, and joy. Advent is a time of expectant watchfulness and waiting. Watchfulness and waiting, done in hope, peace, love, and joy. It is a time to embrace the spiritual disciplines of preparation, penitence, and prayer. And most importantly, it is a time to remember who and whose you are while watching, waiting, and living in the promise of God's new kingdom. Watchfulness and waiting. Pray with me, please. God of power unexpected, we want you to tear open the heavens and come down, to make mountains quake, water boil, and stars to fall until all nations tremble at your presence. But you will not perform according to our wants and whims. Instead, you come like the sound of sheer silence, thin, quiet. Instead, you are born among us in an infant. Instead, you show us how love is made perfect in weakness. So, dear God, we will stay alert. We will stay awake because we are your people and there is no other God besides you. Amen. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Rejoice, Emmanuel.
Turn now to our church concerns for this first Sunday of Advent. We again would like to invite you to join us for our pandemic prayer ministry. It meets Monday through Friday at 9 a.m. Please call in to this prayer ministry. Invite your friends. There's just so much support, care, and love in this ministry. And these are the things that will sustain you as we continue to wade our way through this pandemic. So join us Monday through Friday, 9 a.m. for our Pandemic Prayer Line Ministry. We turn now to our healing and recovering list. We have new names on the list this Sunday. Please keep James Beasley, Jacqueline Early, Elder Michael Williams, the brother of Myron Williams, in your prayers. And add to our bereavement list the family of William Tanner and the passing of his sisters, Teresa and Shirley. A final shout out to our November birthdays and anniversary celebrants. We hope this has been a wonderful month for you, and we continue to wish you all the happiness that your heart can hold as you celebrate yet another milestone in this, the only life you've ever known. May God continue to bless you and keep you. We turn now to our giving report. Our giving report has been good, and we thank you so much for the generosity that you have shown to Church of the Master and her ministry in this virtual place and in our actual physical place at 3400 MLK Junior Drive. Please continue to give generously to this ministry. You make the difference. You bless us so that we might bless others. Now, there are three ways that you can give. There are three options that we offer: PushPay, PayPal, or you can just drop it in the U.S. mail. And if these options don't appeal to you, if they just don't work, please contact our clerk of session and she'll be happy to make arrangements to pick up your offering. May God continue to bless you and keep you. As we turn toward our closing today, we'd like to thank the Trice family, our Advent readers, for a wonderful job here on today. Elder Zettler Clay IV, our liturgist, just week in and week out, just blesses us and does such an outstanding job. Master Brendan Michael, our scripture reader, and Elder Anthony Meadows, who week in and week out does such an exceptional job on producing what you see virtually. So again, we'd like to thank them for all that they have done, and we'd be remiss if we did not thank our virtual Church of the Master musicians, Mrs. Sheila Wheat Harris and Ms. S. Renee Clark. A parting word. As we enter into this season of expectation and hope, I'd like to ask you to give thanks with a grateful heart. Give thanks to the Holy One. Give thanks because God has given us Jesus Christ. Give thanks for the body of Christ, the church. Give thanks for family and friends near and far. Give thanks for happy memories made and happy memories yet to be made. Give thanks because God has truly been good to us. And on that note, I'd like to ask that you go in peace, knowing that God loves you, Jesus died for you, and the Holy Spirit is always around to support you and sustain you. Until we gather again virtually in this place, I am the Reverend Dr. Cecilia A. Taylor, pastor of Church of the Master Presbyterian Church, USA, located in Atlanta, Georgia. Blessings.